So, warm good afternoon to all viewers, sirs, and all the others present in this Google Meet link. So, today we have the webinar session on the topic of basics of well completion in oil and gas industry. And to enlighten that topic, this topic is very lively industrial topic. And to enlighten that lively industrial topic, we have one eminent personality with us, that is Dr. A.K. Srivastava sir from the ONGC. And before starting the topic of or before starting before hand over to the sir, I will just take a few minutes, since we have a very short period of time. So I will just take a few minutes to start the webinar and to introduce the sir, then we will start the webinar. So going for the introduction part, to start the introduction part, the Srivastava sir has 41 years of vast experience in oil and gas industry, with specialization in most of the production technology area, and those area which are first executed or implemented in the part of continented related to the simulation. The Srivastava sir has core competencies in the stimulation of oil and gas, water, coil tubing, well completion, workover operation, artificial lift, and many more. Presently, the Srivastava sir is working as a consultant for oil and gas production companies in India and across the globe. Like we have Focus Energy, Jindal Drilling, Prabha Energy, and other than this, Srivastava sir is organizing various courses also on the well safety and the well completion for the oil companies. So since we have very eminent personality in the industry today, so I hope we'll get a better insight view of petroleum world, a better insight view of oil and gas industry today. So now I will hand over to the Srivastava sir. Sir, the session is all yours.
Okay. So good afternoon to everyone. I'm going to talk on the completion, as Dr. Jan has told to do that, right? Are you people able to listen my voice and everything? Yeah. Are you able to listen my voice and everything?
Sir, yes, sir, everyone is able to hear you, sir.
Okay, very good. So well completion, actually it is a process of making a well ready for production or injection after drilling operation. So when we start a drilling of the well, and well has been drilled and the hole is ready, now we can say we start our completion activities. But we don't start this completion these days from there. Actually, when we plan our well, when we make a geological technical order for any well, then what will be the depth, which how many will be the reservoir, what kind of things will be there, that time actually we incorporate with the drilling and geologist and decide about the completion also, because completion required lot of hardwares. So suddenly somebody says ki I need a particular equipment, or as per the well requirement or reservoir requirement, you need some item that may not be available on the shelf. So that's why this is very important step for anybody who is associated with the completion, that he involve himself from the starting of the drilling. So accordingly, we decide what kind of completion is required to be done. And when the well is ready, hole is ready, and the casing and liner is going to be lower on that time we have to prepare all our jewelry, all our hardwares, and be ready for the call from the drilling site. So basically, what I had written also here, this is a process to make well ready for production after drilling operation. So what are the steps covered under that? That is a casing and liner, cementing. Of course, this is a part of drillers. But many places, this is also included in the completion. So then the perforation and placement of completion equipment in the well. So what are the main completion equipments? That is, first thing is tubing, then packer, then subsurface safety wall, some landing nipples, any other item as per the well condition. And on the surface, we put Christmas tree, choke assembly, and subsurface surface safety wall. So this is the basic concept of this. Here I will give you idea of the well. This is, if you see, it is we are having actually casing also of the different type. So first we put, it is a conductor pipe, then surface casing, then intermediate casing, then production casing, and then perforated intervals in the production casing. So this is just a line diagram. I'll go another to elaborate this more. If you see, we put some conductor casing on the top. It may be 100 meter to 300 meter anywhere. And then we put a surface casing, then intermediate casing, and this is a production liner, and this is your tubing. So this is what I am saying. This is for a complicated or a deep well. But depending on the different companies, the casing policy may vary. Some people are using three casing policy, some people are using four casing policy, and even the deeper well, we may go for the five casing policy also. But deciding that what kind of casing we are going to put or what kind of the liner we are going to use, this depends on many things, like what we are going to produce, what is the depth, and what are the safety conditions or the statutory conditions required of the place. Why I am saying? Because optimization of this is very important. Because if you see, the most costly part of any well is the cost of casing. Okay. So here, if you see, it is a well, I am trying to Christmas tree and wellhead. Then it is having subsurface safety wall. Then we are having some flow couplings. Then sliding doors are also being used in many places. Then side pocket mandrels, if it is required for any injection or for chemical injection or gas injection, whatever we want. Then we put landing nipples. Then locator seal assembly. And this is the packer mainly. And now you see it is a casing. Here is some landing nipples again. This is a perforated pipe. Sometimes we hang some perforated pipe with the packer. And this is a mole shoe, some people say, but we say wildline entry guide. Because if you are doing any wildline operation in the well, then you should be able to allow when the tool is coming back, then it should come easily. There should be no instruction or no collar available to that. So if you see here, this is one more diagram for the same thing. It is having a tubing here, then it is a packer. Because in the simple way, if you see, we after complete this wells, when the casing has been done, in the completion part, we are mainly concerned with the tubing and packer. So this is here, the inner part, it is a production tubing by which we try to take production, and it is a packer. So packer, why we use packer? Because I told you the casing is the most costly part, so we have to protect our casing. If you allow to flow some liquid from the annulus, or which is going to the casing in the time, it may damage it. And if the casing is damaged, your whole well, you had lost the whole well. So that's why these packers completion is very important. Now, if you see here, it is a tubing, which I had shown you in the well. Now you can see this look like this way, and it is stacked like this. So when I'm talking, there's a two most important element, that is, one is tubing, another is packer. So packer, we are available packers in the industry, the different kind of packers are available as per the utilization and as per the well condition. So we are having some retrieval mechanical packers, which are which can be retrieved as and when required. Then some permanent packers are there, which you have to put, then it will be a permanent part of the well. And suppose you want to go and do some work or operation or something, then you have to mill this packer, then only it is possible to retrieve. Then there are some packers which can be set by rotation. Then some packers are hydraulic set production packers. Then we are having the latest technology available, that is the inflatable packers. And then there are some packers which is a compression set packers, then tension set packers, and swell packers. This is swell packers are again a very it is a new and latest technique where you have not to do anything. You have to lower this packer simply with the tubing, and when it comes in the contact with the well fluid, it will automatically swell and seal the system. But many times we are not using this packer for permanent completion. This is being used for isolation or for doing any fracturing operation or anything on the well. So now I'll show you some picture of the packer. So this is a packer, one mechanical packer you can see here. It is having a sealing, this is which holds the casing, and there are the seals which lock for the liquid. Now, what I told you, this is an inflatable packer. This is a very simple one. It goes with the tubing, and when you apply the pressure, it will inflate, and this will hold the your casing and everything. So this is the thing is there. Now we are using subsurface safety valve. This is one of the very important thing these days, because if any uncontrolled flow is coming because of any reason, then this subsurface safety valve will close automatically, because it is pressure driven. When it is having a hydraulic line from the surface, and which gives a permanent some pressure on this, and the flapper, it is having some flappers which are open. Now the oil is coming and on the surface, but this. But when the velocity increases, so this balance, what the pressure we are giving from the top is reversed. It means this pressure, what we are giving from the top, becomes less, and the bottom pressure becomes more. In that condition, these flappers get automatically closed, and they cut off the oil production on the surface. So this is one of the very important thing. If some of you people know, when we got an accident in the Bombay High, when platform was drawn, so all the well could has been saved because of using this type of subsurface valve. Because when there was a platform, the resistance on the top has gone, then the oil or gas has started producing in a faster way. Then these all valves worked nicely and they got closed. So it has saved the much more bigger tragedy on the platform. So these are the some landing nipple what I had shown. They are having a different profile. These are used many times for keeping something in the mind for future requirement, or if you are having a hydraulic packer, then for putting a plug and setting that, and after setting that packer, that plug can be removed through slick line on the surface. Or suppose you want to put any downhole gauge or something like that, then also these landing nipples are very important and they are being used because they are having a specific group. So whatever the tool you want to use in future or at the time of completion, that time you can match with that group, and when that tool goes in the bottom, it will fit automatically there and it will sit. So some other type of completions, what I have taught so far, it is a very general type which is normally used in the industry. But other type of completions are like gravel pack screen completions, then artificial lift equipments, then we use sometime the blind or perforated hanging string that has been done, because nowadays instead of vertical wells we are doing lot of high deviated wells or horizontal wells. So the use of this technology has increasing, and then multilateral well. This is one of the very important and economical way of producing. By here, what we do, we keep one mother hole, and then we make different laterals from there, and then you can get 4-5 times production from a instead of a single well. So I'll come in little detail on other things again, but now I like to show you the top completion system. That is a Christmas tree. What you must be knowing, it is an assembly of different walls. We are having, these are the flow walls, these are the two master walls. It is having a crown wall, and here it is an endless walls. Now you see, this is the actual figure. Earlier you had seen a picture, now it is, you can see it is actual. There are two master walls, one crown wall, two flow walls, and these are the envelope wall. Now you can see the same when it is been placed. It is a picture, is not very clear, but it is taken in the actual field in the Rajasthan. So this is a well we are having. Of course, here this is the old well, so we are having only one master wall, one wing wall, one crown wall, and then it is having a flow wall here also. And these are the some needles or some gauges or something, whatever you want to put, you can do here. So there nowadays you must have heard about subsea completions, where we put our Christmas tree deep on the surface in the sea itself. So this is a much complex system, and it is all having electro hydraulic lines, which you can see here from the top or the from the platform. You can provide all the signals here, and the wall, any wall you want to close or open or whatever action you want to do, you can do through electro hydraulic signals. Here you are trying to see, these are some repair vessels which sometimes we use. Even the man, if it is not very deep, the people can go, or the divers can go, and they can take a repair job if it is needed. So now it is a choke assembly. It is again a part of surface. This is required because when you are suppose in a field and you are having 20-25 wells are there, and most are some wells are having different pressure and other wells are having different pressure, but when these all wells are connected to the GGS, that is called a group gathering station, where we collect oil or gas from all the wells, Then there the equipment, what called the separator, which separates the oil and gas, or oil and water or whatever is there. So those separators are having a uniform pressure. So you require that most of the well, what are connected to them, they are maintaining the same pressure. For that, we are using this choke assembly. This is the oil is coming from here, and this is having a adjustable system, and then the oil is going there. So what we see, even the pressure here may be 50, but if we want here that our separators are suppose on 16 kg, then the pressure here at this place should not be more than the 16 kg plus the traveling pressure required. It may be 18, 20 kg. So accordingly, we put the choke, or sometimes what happens, because in the concept, good production concept, we say not a maximum production, it should be optimum production. So if you want to optimize your well production, then also you can decide a smaller entry for getting the less production. So here you can see surface safety valve with setup. Here we are, if you see, we put a surface safety valve, and it is having lot of electronic and hydraulic system. It is having a well control panel. So this is also works on automatic system. Suppose there is an emergency or anything is there, then this valve will close. And why this is important? Because suppose this line is going to the GGS, or it may be a 10 kilometer line, and there is any leakage or anything is there, then this valve should work and automatically shut the system. So this is a surface safety valve with this setup. And okay, now let us go back again in the completion system. I just given an introduction to you. Now, well completion types, that is a very important. Suppose you are a completion man or completion engineer, then how to decide about the completion? So method and mods vary. They depend on what is the most important thing is the type of reservoir or geology in the area, and fluid to be produced. Then what fluid we are going to produce? Because why these two things are very important? Because suppose the reservoir is having some free sand or something like that, then you have to choose a gravel pack system or screens, or according to requirement, your completion equipment. And fluid is again very important to decide the metallurgy. What metallurgy you are going to use? Suppose a well is producing H2S, then you have to select your metallurgy accordingly. And suppose it is having a carbon dioxide, some percentage, then you require again to be alert for deciding what metallurgy is required to be used. Then pressure, of course. Pressure is one of the deciding factor, because suppose the your reservoir pressure is 8,000 or 7,000, then you have to select the tubular or other thing which should be 10,000 PSI. Otherwise, they will collapse there itself. So that is there. Then availability of equipments. I told you they are the three guiding factors. But the fourth, which is the actual practical thing, what is available with you? Because sometime you suppose you require, it is having a high H2S or anything is there, then it says you require a metallurgy which should have 23% or 13% chrome metallurgy. But suppose in Kaloy, 23% metallurgy equipments is not available, then to produce it, what you will do? You will compromise there and you will put a 23% chrome or even lesser, considering that suppose I put this equipment and they are having a life of 3 years or 4 years. So we'll again come with a worker and we'll change the pipes. So that is, again, as a completion engineer, you have to make all calculation, and going with the company policies, you have to decide that you have to, whatever equipment is available, because you have to complete your well. Because the per day production or the rig cost is such that that also becomes many times governing factor. And ultimately, when we are talking all these, the most important thing for any engineer is cost factor. Suppose you say, I'm going to use Incolai tubing and this material, that material, many sensors or many complicated things. Everything requires cost. And your well cost becomes, suppose, 50 crores or 100 crores. Then even your company owners or your managers may say, what useless man is there? We were earlier completing the well in 20 crores. Now he's asking 50 crores. And I'm not seeing any direct advantage of doing that. So this is very important factor to consider, the cost factor. Now, if you see completion fluid, if we come here, considering this all, one factor I had left, that is a safety. Because whatever you are selecting, whatever you are going to do, that should be safe enough. And that should be efficient also. And then what we are talking, it is a completion fluid. Normally, drilling has been done with a heavy mud. But when we switch over for completion, we change all the fluid and we go with the solid free fluid. This is because whatever you had seen, the packer and other things, they may not work properly, or they may not even work if any solid is there and that goes in the groove of the system. So now you had. Let us talk something about different type of completion. Here, if you see, we are having the cased hole, then open holes, single completion, dual completion, then artificial lift completions, that is a gas lift, ESP, SRP, jet pumps, screw pumps. Then, if you go here down, we are having segment completion, multi-zone completions, intelligent completions. I'll come in detail. Multilateral completions, combination or specialized completions. So these are the major type of completion which industry is using at this time. Sometime you must have heard talking the people, they divide this completion in two parts. They say it is a lower completion or higher completion. Actually, what I told, it is a part of that only. But some people categorize in this in the two part. The lower part, they say, which is coming in the direct touch with the reservoir. And the upper, what they say, it is the Christmas tree and the tubular which is hanging in the system. So here I touch this because you should not get confused. If anybody is talking to you that what is lower completion, what is upper completion. Now, whatever I had told you, let us go in the short, because we are not, it is a big subject and we are not having that time, but I'll try to touch most of the thing in the short. This is a multi-zone completion. It is a single vertical well. We are putting, it is having two zones. One and two, but we are using one packer. I told you that the packer is must, and we should not allow any liquid to come in the contact of the casing. But in the industry, if you see some places where the oil quality is very good and it is a pure oil, then to save money, we try to produce for some time or temporarily this oil from the annulus also. That is a production casing and production tubing annulus. So here you see, this is the example. where the one zone is producing through the annulus and another zone is being produced through the tubing. And this is why we are not producing both things together, because the reservoir pressure in the both zone is different. Now you see, it is a single string dual zone two packer. Here, the zones, there is a two zones, but the pressure is more or less same. Then what we are doing, we are putting two packers, one and two. This is isolating the total upper part of the well. And here we are using some perforated pipes or sometimes sliding sleeve to produce this particular zone. And from the down, it is a normal. So both zones are producing together and in the single string. But now suppose you are more intelligent and you don't want to allow your annulus should come in the contact of oil. Then you, what you can do? It is a two zones. You can use two tubing string in the one well. This is called a dual string completion, where we are using a packer which is having a dual packer. It allows to pass two tubing together. And one is a feed-through system where the tubing comes down, and here is the seal packer. And this is, you are having some perforation packer. So this is coming, the oil is coming from this portion, and this is going with this string. And the longer string, what this is called, we are producing the down zone. So this is one example, and this is all been done and used in the industry. Now, I had touched earlier, this is a gravel pack completion, right? So what is gravel? Actually, when this is a reservoir, and here we are having a loose sand. So this is a production formation, and we are having loose sand. So if you start producing this as such, what will happen? This loose sand will also start coming up. It may choke your tubing, or it may choke on the surface system. Then what we have to do? We have to put some gravel. Gravel is again a sand, or it is matching with the reservoir geometry things. So that we have to pump here in the system. And this is, we are having a gravel pack screen. So that has been, first we have to pump the gravel, then we have to put the screen. So this gravel will stop whatever sand is, loose sand is there, it should not come here. And this screen will stop this gravel to come back on the surface. So this is and here, whatever is there, it is either perforated or it is a slanted liner. So gravel, nowadays, the better technique has been adopted. That is, we go for a frack pack. So what we do, instead of normal, this perforation, normal perforations has been done, then we pump this gravel with high pressure. So they generate some bigger holes or fractures where the sand goes and pack itself. And then we put our screen, so this increases the productivity of the well. How it looks actually? This looks like this in the actual. So here is the production tubing. It is a production casing. It is a gravel pack packer we use here. And it is a gravel placed. This is all gravel what we had placed there. And this is a screen. And this is a sump packer, which don't allow to fall down your gravel or whatever sand is there in the sump. So actually, when we do this job, this look like this way. Okay. Now we'll go. You, boy, you people are listening many things on the intelligent completions. So what is that? The most important thing for intelligent completion means we are using lot of electronics, lot of hydraulics or hydroelectrical system to control our well. what is the main advantage in this system by use of technology? Here, any well which is having 3 zones, 4 zones, or 5 zones, you can produce together. But what is the risk earlier? Suppose you use the old system, then the risk is, suppose any particular zone becomes the water bearing. Suppose these zones become the water bearing. Then water velocity is more. Then what it will do, it will subdue this zone. It will subdue production of this, and you will see that you are getting mostly water or more water from the same well. So earlier, we were using sliding sleeve system. We were putting sliding sleeve 1, 2, and 3. But that system was many times, it was not working because sand or any solid has been accumulated on the sliding sleeve side. So when, or because of the corrosion, when you go and you want to close this sliding sleeve, you see this is not getting closed. Now it is a modified version and we are having different kind of walls here. So suppose this zone is started producing water, then from the surface itself, you can close this particular wall and you see that production has started coming from this and this only. Or suppose this is earlier it was producing with 10% water, but it is now increased to 80% or 70%. So as a company, or I say, whatever the oil is left there, that should also be produced. So what we can say, we can reduce the inflow from this particular wall, and then we see, we can balance it. A situation where some oil is coming from this also along with water, but it is not that quantity that it subdues this zone or this zone. So here you see in this system what we do. These are the different packers we put. It may be inflatable packers, it may be swell packers, what I told you earlier. So when we run this total assembly in the well, this goes, and when it is there for 12 hours or 24 hours, these packers get activated and they seal it. And now, but one thing is there, one or two or three control lines are coming here from the surface. These, where with the hydraulic pressure from the surface, you are controlling this system. And many times in this system, we put different gauges also. That is to understand how much quantity is coming from this zone, how much quantity is from this zone, how much quantity is coming from this zone. And then what is the temperature or what is the pressure at present particular reservoir? Because for afterwards, doing a reservoir study in such wells is difficult. So that's why we put from the starting some gauges in that. So they are also providing the continuous data on the surface about the temperature, pressure, or flow, whatever you want. But naturally, these completions are costly. They are complicated. And you have to take care whether you are going to do this type of completion in the starting. Otherwise, suppose this type of completion is taking 7-8 days of the rig. And if suppose this well is in the offshore or it is a deep sea, then the rig cost is too much. Where your counterpart of the drilling people will start crying that you are taking too much time and it is increasing my cost of the well. So that's why it should be decided in the starting. I told you, the work of a completion engineer start when we are planning. Because in the starting, when you had planned, no, we have to go for this well because of the 5 zones as an intelligent well or a smart well, then you have to put accordingly the completion time, 8 days or 10 days. So ultimately, until 8 days or 10 days, nobody will question you that you are taking more time for completing the well. So this is some example of the horizontal wells now. many times we are using this technology, what I had shown you in the horizontal section also. Because movement in this horizontal section is tough. So what to do in this system? And what initial days, what we are doing, when we were coming here, we were cutting a window and going in this area. So basically, this there is a no restriction or no casing, no liner in this portion. So this was an open hole completion. And we put our tubing wherever or whatever distance it was possible to go, and we leave our tubing also there. Or sometimes, suppose we are having a packer at this place, then we were having hanging our this production string with a perforated tubing or perforated liner, whatever is required. But that was creating a lot of problems, because many times we see the hole is collapsing, this hole is collapsed, and your production is suddenly reduced. Or whatever is there, all the liquid will try to come from here, and there it will try to enter at the toe of the well. So what was happening? The water cut has been seen. It is more prominent in such wells, or it is collapsed. So if you want to intervene, some of the production has been reduced, and your people are saying, you just go and see why the production is reduced. When you are trying to go with a coil tubing, you say that you are not able to go in the such wells. Then they say, what kind of completion you people has done? Or the CTU people will get abused that you are not know how to do this type of job. But nobody was realizing that what is happening actually. Normally, this type of thing were done in the limestone, where they consider the limestone is not non-collapsible. But if you see in the nature, nothing is pure. There is a many silt and salts are there with the lime. So even the lime is, they are collapsing or they are depositing here in the hole and causing the choking of the system. So what has been started doing then? Then we started putting, here is the packer I told you, and then the perforated liner or system, which is pre-drilled, and that is being put in the well. So once it is being done as a completion part, so they are providing two things. One thing, whatever production is coming, it is coming through this tubular, because this is the most easy part. And then it is avoiding to collapse up to some extent. So this time of completion has been also done. And here also what we had done, if you see, we had put two packers there. So we were trying, most of the toe section we are closing here, and we are trying to produce from the far area. Now, if you see, now with the latest technology, what I had shown you, the intelligent system, we go for such wells, completing with the perforated liner or with a casing or liner up to the end. And then we perforate these portions. And even we go for hydrofracturing of such section, and then we produce. So by doing this technology, by using this technology, you can produce even 2-3 times or 5 times from the normal well. So this has been also used. But normally, this type of technology we use from the reservoirs where we can produce high production can be taken. Now, we had talked something for artificial lift. So here is the picture of the SRP. You people are in Baroda. So you must have seen some SRPs working when you are going towards the Cambay side, or anybody is going to the Ahmedabad. So this is the SRP we put, and there is a sucker rod pump. It is like your water pumps, water hand pumps mostly. So, but it has been put in the well at the depth of 1500 meters or 2000 meters, depending on the requirement. And it is much bigger than that. And it has been mechanically operated from the surface. And here, if you see, It is a small setup on the well instead of that big Christmas tree what we are using. I'll just go in a short minute. Suppose how we do this completion job. The key person is the completion engineer. Then we are having some completion specialist, completion supervisor, then completion operator, and some assistant operator. Normally, 3 or 4 person team is working on the rig because this completion has been done either on the drilling rig or on the workover rig. So we put this much manpower on that. With this, I like to say thank you to you all people who are listening me. Or if you want a small question answer session, I'll most welcome for asking any question. Now hand over to Dr. Jain, please.
Thank you, sir. There are some questions from the students and the viewers.
Yeah.
So I would like to ask from them. So one of the questions from the student is that, sir, since we have different completion process for sandstone and carbonate reservoir rock, so what are the difference in the process of sandstone and the carbonate reservoir?
Okay. Normally, what is happening when we are having a sand stone reservoir or this limestone reservoir? Normally, it is considered that the limestone reservoir is more consolidated, and there is a chance of coming some sand or some perforation particles are less. That's why the completion in limestone reservoir is considered much easier, and you required less jewelry. Wherever when you are doing this in the sand reservoir, many times you see that the sand is consolidated, then it is having a same system what we are using. There is no difference between sandstone and reservoir if the sandstone reservoir is consolidated. But if it is a loose, then you require a special arrangement, that is a gravel pack or any other method to stop the sand. Most commonly used is the gravel pack, but gravel pack is also having some limitations. Many times it reduces the productivity of the well. So for that, I told here that we are doing a new technology that is called frac pack, where we first generate the frac, then we put the gravel, and then we complete the well to take this production from the well. But suppose it is having a consolidation, but very little quantity of sand is coming, then what we do, we can just simply hang some screens across the perforation, and then we allow to produce the well. So whatever what is happening, whatever the sand is coming, it is stopped across the screen. But then you have to go for the reverse wash of the well frequently as per the requirement. Or otherwise, suppose some sand comes on the surface, then we put some sand sensors. They allow us and they tell whatever the quantity is sand, because if the sand is coming on the surface, it can damage your Christmas tree, it can damage your line, or it can damage your equipment at the installation. So that's why we put some sand sensors, and that has been fixed with this, that this much sand will be allowed, which is safe to travel. So accordingly, suppose if the sand quantity started increasing, then either one way is that you have to stop production for some days and allow to settle down the sand. And then after a few days, you can reopen with suppose earlier you were producing 100 barrels, so you can put the choke and start with 50 barrels and see how well is behaving. I think this will suffice.
Yes, I think the queries of viewer has solved completely from this answer.
Yeah.
Sir, the next question we have from our BTech student, fifth semester. that why we need to open needle valve when we check pressure using pressure gauge located on Christmas tree.
Needle valve is the most safe way because it's the name. It allows only a needle like place to communicate with you and the well. Because if you put any bigger thing, more pressure will come. And then needle valve is being used there and we keep the outer end open. Because what is happening, this is a more environmental problem. Suppose you put a gauge, permanent gauge on the well, above the needle valve or in the line. So sometimes you see the people are miscreant. They damage your this gauge or they will try to steal it. So they can cause an accident. That's why we put a needle valve there. And whenever we go there, we first open. If there is any liquid or any condensate is being trapped there, that is been also released. And then we put our gauge and we take the pressure from that. That is the purpose of putting a needle valve. And because the high quantity of gas or oil should not come across, that's why a very small, or it is a half inch, if the threads are half inch, but the opening is sometime, it is hardly 2 to 3 mm only. Right?
Okay, sir. Okay. The next question we have from one of our viewers, and that is, do we use any type of softwares during the completion, during the designing of the completion of well?
Yeah, we can use different software used by different companies, but they are mainly for the flow calculations, flow and pressure calculations, right? So because the what is most important, how much oil or gas we are going to produce, though, then what size of tubulars we have to use, what size of the packer we have to use, how much perforation is required there, that is all decided by using various software, and that are many times it is a company specific or especially tailor-made for different companies, right? And okay, earlier, being your students are a petroleum engineer, you must be knowing the nodal analysis.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. We teach the student about the nodal analysis.
So nodal analysis also gives the rough idea. What should be the size of the tubular or things should be put depending on the production. Okay, sir.
Another question. Since we have very short period of time, so I am taking just a few questions. Another question from the semester third student of our BTech, and that is, can we increase the safety of well by using the artificial intelligence?
Certainly. But normally, as a completion man, it is your prime duty that you have to make a system that should be safe enough. And that should be not safe enough when you are completing. It should be safe enough throughout the life of the well. That is a subject. We say well integrity. Okay? That's again that is again a big subject. But naturally, whenever you are using a computer or this your artificial intelligence, naturally, that adds the value in the system.
Yes, sir. One of the questions we have, I think this question will be from you, that how to be a good completion engineer, a good completion man?
Okay. So that is the most, what is most important? Your completion should be efficient, but in the same time, it should be the cost intensive. Because when you are in the technical field, when you are in the commercial area, the everything governs with the cost. If you see, there's a world politics. It was governed earlier days. And even now also, with the oil production or the crude politics, why it is happening? Because a lot of money is involved in this industry. And yes, when sir. You are producing a well, suppose my well is having a life for, suppose, 20 years, then I have to see that how much we are going to put in that and what ultimately we are going to produce. So everything becomes the cost, or it is a matter of our finance people. They look everything and accordingly they allow you to work. Right? So there yes, is a sir. Certain things what you have to look as a, for the best thing. You have not to compromise technically for the safety, yes. what my friend was asking. Yes, there should be yes, no sir. Compromise with the safety. We should try to produce yes, optimum, and that should be simple and cost effective.
Yes, sir. A lot of the money is involved in the industry. That's why the crude oil is also known as black gold. And yes. I think the reason of most of the war that happens in the world is due to the crude oil only.
I have not told you, I told you simply that it is a lot of politics goes because of that.
Sir, last question is that since a lot of the industries are now involved in the renewable energy sectors, so what is the future of crude oil?
Naturally, renewable energy is much cheaper system and but the success, whatever we are getting for renewable energy, is not that much or not that much sufficient to replace the oil industry. So at least for another yes, 50 to 100 years, minimum 50 years, yes, oil industry is going to be the key factor.
Yes, sir. Yes. Okay, so since we have a very short period of time and I cannot take anyone's question, if you have, we can share the email ID of the sir also. If you find any questions regarding the well completion, yeah. I can share the email ID. You can share the email ID if you can share on the screen.
Yeah. Just you can note, it is a very simple, it is with my name, yes, A-N-I-L. ONGC @gmail.com is very simple.
Okay, Anil, so if you have any questions, if you want anything, sir will help.
Yeah, certainly.
The sir is very much helpful to the young professionals of the petroleum engineering world.
Yeah.
So finally, concluding the session, thank you so much, Srivastav sir, for enlightening us and giving us the best possible right way to the different well completion method. We have different well completion equipment and about some inside view of the petroleum industrial world. So I hope the viewers, the students of the Parul University and other university, those who are joined in that link, have get a better insight and get a better knowledge of the petroleum world. So sir, I owe you a special vote of thanks on the behalf of Parul University. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you so much for giving your valuable time for us. And I hope in the future, whenever we require any assistance, any guidance from you, you will give us.
Yeah, there's no problem. And I love to talk with my young boys, young brothers, to discuss or solve their problem. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Okay, sir. Yeah. Thank you so much, sir. Okay. So,